Good morning, children. Today, I will explain 10th class social studies under paper 2, 14th lesson. The World Between Wars from 1900 to 1950, part 2. Earlier, we finished paper 1, paper 1, second lesson. And before, we finished about the 14th lesson, part 1, that is about Russia, I.V. Lenin and Joseph Stalin. Details we discussed in previous class. Now we are going to discuss the important part, that is the Great Depression, in part 2. So what is Great Depression? Great Depression, why it happened? So I will explain very detailed manner what is meant by Great Depression. What is meant by Great Depression? So first of all, we discuss what the topic name is called Great Depression. Great Depression. Great Depression take place in 1929 and ends 1939. First it starts in America, later it expanded to Germany and other European world, afterwards entire world. So, it starts in Germany. But here one important thing. What happens in America? Nearly 25% is unemployment, which is happened. 25% is unemployment. Nearly 33% of production sector will decrease. And it affects not only industrial sector but also agriculture sector. So that's why here I am telling about Great Depression, which is started in America and it later expands to Germany and other nations. So here one important point I will say, whether Russia is affected in Great Depression or not, that is also very important. The Great Depression starts in America. America collapsed. It means the stock market of America is collapsed because the market prices are collapsed. Fell down. Market prices is fell down. Then automatically stock is more. Then supply is more. Then demand is less. So number of goods which is outcome from the factories, but nobody is ready to buy the goods. So that's why what happens here, you see, there is no equality between demand and the supply, because of in the place of human being working in the factories, the human beings are totally, workers are totally removed. In the place of workers, machinery introduced. Automatically, when machinery introduced, the number of goods producing capacity is enhancing day by day. It means there is no proper equality between demand and the supply. When demand and the supply is not equal, ultimately, the market will be collapsed. The prices of all goods fell down. Then, the production is heavy compared to the demand. So, in all markets, number of goods are there. So, but buying capacity of a consumer is not in proper way. So, ultimately, market fell down. In Germany, the situation is very serious. How it happens in Germany, in Germany there is no proper work, proper employment. All factories are locked down and all factories are shut down because of production is heavy, that's why. And there is no salaries for workers. The workers are not having any proper food. Lot of looties are happened. Lot of, robberies are happened for food only and other goods also later. So in Germany, this position is very serious. How the Germany position is very serious? Why? Because all factories are closed. Unemployment which is happened. And already unemployed youth is there and this is already removed workers and both are, it means double unemployment. So that's why they are hanging on cardboard and they wrote that we are ready to do any type of work for one meal, for a day. We are ready to work any type of work. We are ready to do any type of work, but I want food. Such type of, placards or cardboards which is hanged in the, neck. And some of the youth which is playing without any work. Nowadays there is no work, that's why everybody is simply sitting in the home. And they are doing different works, but which is not useful. Like that, at that time in Germany, youth, especially youth, playing cards by sitting in the streets. So this is very, very bad activities. And some of the members are started occupy different types of private grocery shops, and they looted material. Such type of thing, bad activities are done. So criminal activity also increased because of without proper work, so proper employment. The unemployed youth malpracticed a lot of things. So severally, the crime mentality of different youth was and different thinking which is happened in the time of Great Depression. Later in Russia, what about the Russia? In Russia, Russia is not related with all other nations in the matter of business. Russia is isolated country. It is not related with all other nations in the matter of world business. So that's why it was escaped from Great Depression. So Russia not affected by Great Depression. Remain almost all world nations affected a lot. At that time, America, how to come out from the Great Depression? How to come out from the Great Depression means here, USA is planning when we get strong economy. Now the economy was collapsed, the stock market of USA is fell down, and number of properties are sold to the common man, to the others, and getting livelihood, food materials, the food material cost is increased, decreased for the farmers, but it is to buy the common man, the food material cost is increased. So this is the thing was happen in America. So at that time, America asked to the great economic expert at the time, known as a great economic expert, that is J.M. Keynes. J.M. Keynes was a great economic expert, and he gave a formula that is called in USA. F.W. Roosevelt. F.W. Roosevelt asked the advisor to the great economist. who is the great economist? I said J.M. Keynes. J.M. Keynes is the economic expert. J.M. Keynes was the economic expert and he gave advices to the American government. What is the advice given by J.M. Keynes? That is 3 R's formula. What is that? 3 R's formula. 3 R's formula to set the economy, to stand the economy, to found the economy, to grow the economy. For that, 3 R's formula, which is set by J.M. Keynes, that is relief, reform, recover. What is called relief and what is called reform? What is called recover? So, relief, reform, recover. What is this 3 R's formula? Relief means giving relief for companies. Reform already existing companies. And recover, getting old position, that is running position of the companies. So, relief. How the companies will get the relief? Means companies is not ready to buy the raw material, ready to not recruited any employee. So that is a very, very nasty condition. There is no financial assistance to the companies. At the time, relief means again giving money to the companies and run the companies. And not asking the financial things, loans. That is called relief. Reform. Reform means what the people need regularly. Such type of goods we ready to produce. Such type of modifications and changes made in the companies. That is called reform. Suppose if the market is fastly run, how it will run? They are thinking about the market, how it will be run. By using of regular goods. What are the regular goods? Regularly what the consumer utilize, such goods companies or such goods factories will run. That is called reform. Later, recover, getting old position. It means smoothly, running the companies. Then the market will be getting soon in strong position. So that is relief, reform, recover. So afterwards, Britain also followed some welfare measures. Britain follows some welfare measures. What are welfare measures? That is, suppose LIC, life insurance, and giving pension to the workers, giving pension to the old age and sick persons, and these two welfare measures along with subsidy based goods which is selling to the poor people. This is also one welfare measure followed by Britain. And afterwards, Britain follows what? That is welfare principles. What is called here now welfare state? Which state is fought for welfare activities for the people? Especially, downtrodden people. Below poverty line people. So, insurance facilities provided to the people as well as subsidy prices, which is given for all the goods for the poor people. Subsidy based goods which is selling for the poor people. And one more, medical facilities also provided free medical facilities also provided to the poor people, and pensions is given, assistance, little bit financial assistance given to the poor people. These are all measures followed by Britain government. So dear students, what I said you think in the mind, and now I am asking question, what that is, what is the period of Great Depression, how the Great Depression is happened, is there in the blackboard, on the blackboard, what that is the period of Great Depression, why the Great Depression was happened. If the demand and the supply is not coincide, then production is very high and the demand is very less, that's why Great Depression is happened. Once again, how the Great Depression is happened, see once, production is high, and what is demand, is demand is low, so there is no equality, according to the demand production is needed or supply is needed, so there is no coincide between the two factors. So anywhere in the world, if the production is not in proper way, then automatically demand is, if the production is high, the demand is also high. So according to the demand, the production or the supply is required. So otherwise, the problem will rise in the economy. Okay, boys, thank you. Today I will stop here, and later I will start another one. Okay.